Hello, and welcome to today's video presentation on customizing a Vagrant file on Oracle Linux. In this video, we will cover the Vagrant file. We will talk about what goes into the file and how to edit it. We will define a Vagrant file with multiple machines, a custom configuration, and provisioning. So let's get started. A Vagrant file defines the machines used within your project and how each of those machines are configured and provisioned. The name is derived from the actual file name used within Vagrant. Each Vagrant project is expected to have only one Vagrant file. When looking for the Vagrant file, Vagrant starts in the current working directory and searches up the directory tree until one is found. When you run the Vagrant up command, Vagrant loads a series of Vagrant files from default locations and merges them. This merge order allows the ability to ship a default config with a box and later override specific settings based on your personal use case. To get started with this demo, it is expected that you already have Vagrant and VirtualBox installed. Open your terminal to create your project directory. This is where you store your Vagrant file and any files used during provisioning. I have already created this demo, which we will review. Start in your home directory and cd to demo/proxyjump. If these directories do not exist, you can create them using /p /demo/proxyjump. I have already created a Vagrant file using touch Vagrant file. Next, open the Vagrant file with your favorite editor. I'll be using Vi for this demo. Once in the Vagrant file, we see Vagrant uses Ruby as indicated by the header. We then created a variable to indicate we are using Vagrant API version 2. To document our configuration, comments are defined by a hash mark at the beginning of the line. If we want to add specific plugins, we can use the next few lines to check if they are installed, and if not, download and install them. In this sample, we are using the Vagrant Reload plugin to allow for reloading of the VM during provisioning, and Vagrant ProxyConf plugin to configure the VM to use proxies defined in the host environment. When processing the Vagrant file, Vagrant works from the outside in when reading the different blocks. Keeping the configuration in this block format also makes the file easier to read. The outer config block starts with the vagrant.configure statement, which takes the API version as a parameter. All items belonging to this block begin with the config name. Let's walk through them. vm.box defines our box image of Oracle Linux 8 latest. .box URL is where to download the box. box_check_update decides if we check our box for updates on every Vagrant up. ssh.insert_key uses the Vagrant default insecure keys for SSH authentication. And vm.syncedFolder, with disabled set to true, disables a synced folder between the host and the VM. To save time during startup in this demo, the vguest.auto_update is set to false. This disables the uptime check to ensure VirtualBox guest additions are up to date and match your host. The Oracle Linux 8 box defaults to 2048 megabytes of RAM. In this V block, we tell the provider VirtualBox to only use 256 megabytes. Now that we have the basics, we can begin to configure our three VMs, which we will call Client, Bastion, and Server. Each machine will define a hostname, a host-only network interface, an internal network interface or two, as well as provisioning steps to configure SSH. VirtualBox uses the VirtualBox Intnet network name option to designate internal networks versus the host-only configuration. Your VM will also have the default NAT network, which VirtualBox puts on the IP address of 10.0.2.15 as a default. For the provisioning statements, the file option is used to copy a file to the VM, while the shell option will execute a command on the VM. Lastly, we define the proxies, set the SSH forwarding ports on the NAT interfaces, and then additional provisioning using an Ansible playbook. The forward ports will auto-resolve conflicts when multiple VMs are used, provided the auto-correction option is set to true. Now that we have reviewed the file, close the file and quit VI using :q bang and then hit enter. Typing ls will show your Vagrant file as well as the files used for provisioning. Issue Vagrant up and the deployment will start. During startup and provisioning, you will see Vagrant move through each machine. Vagrant will define the NAT, host only, and internal network adapters and assign the port forwards for NAT. Finally, it will complete each of the provisioning steps. For fun, if you have the CowSafe package installed, you will see ASCII cows documenting each step of your Ansible playbook. In this video, we created a Vagrantfile which defined 3 VMs and 2 separate private networks. We then provisioned those systems with predefined SSH key pairs to ensure secure communication between them. Vagrant has many additional configuration options available for the Vagrantfile. Details can be found on their website in their online docs. Thank you for watching and hope you enjoyed this video. To find additional resources on Oracle Linux, please check out our Oracle Linux curriculum at education.oracle.com/linux, Oracle Cloud Infrastructure at cloud.oracle.com, and additional training on Oracle Linux on cloud infrastructure at the URL provided.